أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
11 verses from the Quran, carved from Indonesian mahogany.
الذين هم في صلاتهم خاشعون
Describing a successful believer.
والذين هم للزكاة فاعلون
One who is sincere, consistent, charitable, chaste, and fulfills their oaths. The carved calligraphy is just one gorgeous detail of the newly built Al Huda Mosque in Fishers, Indiana.
When I first walked in here, I was absolutely shocked. I was floored. I just could not believe how beautiful it was and how much work had gone into it and how they had really perfected everything.
That's not an understatement. No detail was overlooked in the design of this $8.8 million house of worship.
This is the most beautiful mosque in all of the United States.
Dr. Nasser Karimian, the imam, speaks with authority. He's served other cities around the country and regards this the magnum opus of general contractor Hassam Wanas.
He wants to say through this work that I want to do something that is really going to be a contribution to all Muslims, that they can come here and feel proud that we've done something truly unique.
The decorative elements are as international as its community members. The carpet is from Turkey, Italian porcelain and mosaics from Spain. The granite is Brazilian and the grand chandeliers are Egyptian.
We have a lot of community members who sponsor different parts of the mosque. It could be furniture, it could be carpet, it could be windows, it could be chandelier, and their own loving memory of their family members who passed away.
Community members like Judy Al-Jabi Nalawi even pitched in as the many hands to make lighter work.
I was here almost every day trying to get this place ready, doing magnificent stuff up high and scut work. But as long as I was part of it, it was great.
The Al Huda Foundation started out in a rented warehouse and has grown alongside Fishers, now including three campuses. This new mosque also acts as a community center with a basketball court and a cafe.
We want to make sure that, you know, the doors are not just figuratively but literally that they're open and that we can have people coming in of all faiths so that we can get to know each other.
She was very big on interfaith gatherings and getting to know people.
The mosque has an interfaith room dedicated to the memory of Fatima Hassuna, a college student who was killed in an accident in 2017.
Fatima, if you had met her, you would know she was very timid, very shy, but she had this personality about her that she was like a compass. Like even as a young age, she was like straightforward and knew what she wanted. So that's where people get together and talk about their differences and what things we have in common, and it's beautiful. And it also has a dome, not as big as this one, but 14 feet of it.
The domes. On a previous Great Day TV, we showed Jessica Hancock hand painting and gilding the artwork in every crevice of this mosque. And now the finished work highlighting a 1,200-pound chandelier imported from Cairo, Egypt.
When you look at art, you're not just looking at the finished piece, you're looking at a process. And the idea is to come to a place like this that is going to give you some sort of tranquility and going to connect you to your creator and at the same time remind you that I also am a work in process. I require a lot of work to become beautiful as well, to become a finished product, to become, you know, a work of art. And so that's sort of the objective behind all of this beautiful art, to have that reflect within you, hopefully, God willing.
Joy Hernandez for Great Day TV.